Here we go. Even though this is the beginning of the video, we're doing it again.
We're gonna do it again.
What is it?
What? Oh, yeah, whoa. Spoiler alert.
Before we get started, we're gonna give a shout out to Mr. Joe Angel from Treasure Hunters Supply. Joe watches Stealth Diggers. He likes a good snap.
He's all right in my book.
That's right. Not only that, he's a treasure hunter supplier. So, in the upcoming weeks, some point in the stealth time continuum, we're going to be field testing some stuff that Joe sent us because he wants to see how it works out in the stealth digger world of Saskatchewan, New Hampshire. And that's what you have to look forward to come. Other than that, here comes the intro.
Saskatchewan, way from the coast.
Good day, stealth diggers, eh?
Hey, is there a lot of hippies in here?
Let's get out of here, quick.
Ah, hell, we've already seen it. Okay.
It is big. In fact, this is the biggest bingo to date. Biggest bingo to date. I'm not lying. This is big. Big. Andy!
He won't even let me peek in the bag.
No, it's no. Big. It takes up the whole damn bag.
Well, thanks for tuning into Stealth Diggers, episode number 99. That's a whole lot of episodes. And I'll say it now, and I've said it before, we don't make metal detecting videos, we make Stealth Digger videos. It's all about this massively awesome group of friends and everything that we do. We just document it, so we have something to watch later on. So what we're going to show you is a bunch of different things that happened to us over the course of this particular week. Now, first we're going to start out with your average go out, look for cellar holes, metal detecting kind of day.
About, let's see, a good 8 inches down.
Then, we're going to show you a package opening that we did from a couple of special guys out in Colorado who just absolutely embrace what we do. And they nailed it with the package they sent us. They put so much thought into it, it's brilliant.
Whoa!
Then, we're gonna go back out into the woods, and we're gonna show you what typically happens, but doesn't typically happen.
We gotta go look.
No.
You're not going over?
No, because then we gotta call the police.
So, stay tuned, enjoy, and I'll be back.
Big silver sound.
Correct.
Or a Model T Ford hubcap.
Yeah, right.
Well?
Aluminum can.
Cup. Is that what it is?
It's like an aluminum cup.
Oh, yeah. But it says Ford on it?
No.
Oh, really? Oh,
it says Bazinga.
Thermos.
Still, as we're looking at this place that we just came up to, this dig marks, why is to anybody would pass that up?
Yeah.
All right. So we're walking around the area because the hole has dig signs. I just dug that bazinga. But I just surface found this.
My best man of white.
And you can see bubbles and stuff. That's an applied top. This is turn of the century glass. It's mint. And you just did what?
This is what town?
In Worcester, Mass.
Worcester?
Worcester.
Worcester. I found like a garter belt latch. Rang up just like a button all day long.
So that happens to we get to these sites and whoever hit them literally just concentrated around the hole and didn't walk 40 feet away.
Mm-hmm. So this was definitely between the lingerie clasp and that bottle find about... Let's see, a good 8 inches down.
Oh yeah, that's a beauty.
Yeah. It's the combination hammer.
Yeah, with the
nail remover
thingy. Very nice.
Oh yeah.
Got an edge?
No.
All right, what's going on over here, Keebs?
I think it's a couple coins. Another button. Damn it. Beach jacket.
Beach jacket. Same here.
Are they buttons?
I think they are. Oh, with the cloth attached.
Well,
I thought they were coins.
Saskatchewan is way from the coast.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Huh. Well, I just got an off-the-hook signal. Very loud. Kick the brush aside and... thing.
Maybe? Oh yeah, let's see what we got here.
I just dug a dog license, okay? Yeah. Guess for which state?
Massachusetts.
Way off.
Way off. Wow. Virginia.
No. Wow. So we know that dog tags are actually pretty cool to dig while metal detecting for several reasons. They have dates.
Yep.
States.
Sometimes the town, too.
Yeah. This has town, state, and year.
Ooh.
It's a double.
Oh. Wow. There's a phone number and everything.
Tucson,
yeah.
Arizona.
Wow. Very well used. Look how it's beveled over.
Huge.
Big old axe head.
Whoa.
Yeah.
What's the story behind that?
Well, there was a tin man, but, you know, Oz never gave anything to him that he didn't...
already have.
Didn't already have, right.
I wanted to. I'm awake.
Read the whole thing?
I hate reading. All right. Big box. Look at that. Talk about shipping service. I only opened it, grabbed the letter. Keebs is going to perform.
All right. Hey, good day, Stilt Diggers, eh?
Hey.
Hey. We recently received an order from the Third Life in which there were some unexpected pleasant surprises. It's long overdue that we show our appreciation to the Stilt Diggers. For all you do in the hobby, the contents are... You want me to read everything?
No, don't. We never read the comment, the contents, because we'd rather have the surprise. But Stealth Cam can show you what's on the letter.
Oh, yeah. We'll do... Oh, this particular one is definitely for me. A small box of hippie bait.
Hippie bait? Nice.
Good one.
Yeah, and a surprise box. All right. So, Bill and Cliff... We're going to open it up now and take a peek at all this.
Awesome, Bill and Cliff. And the thing that I wanted to say that we get a lot of these packages, and sometimes they have to sit here for a couple of weeks till a fair amount of us get together so we can all enjoy it.
We have to do them in true justice.
Which we're about to do.
That's fun. Very well done.
Yeah.
Professional letter, by the way.
Absolutely.
Bill's a good writer.
Yeah. It's custom.
All right.
Whoa!
Whoa!
Whoa. Wow!
What's all this stuff?
Squinch. There's a squanch in here.
Sam squanch me.
Wow, this is a heavy package too.
Yeah.
Wow.
Stealth Diggers.
Dude,
Shack snacks.
Yeah. Oh my God! What is that?
What is that?
Is this squanch Domino's?
It's a research kit.
Oh! Oh
no. Big way.
On the hunt, baby.
Holy schmoly, guy.
Don't ruin the sticker, dude.
A badge.
Field journal.
Yeah.
Day 1, August 15th. 6 hours on location, saw nothing. August 20th, 5 days in, saw nothing. August 30th, real quiet. Saw nothing. September 3rd, 12 miles from camp, saw nothing. Morning of September 10th, heard something. September 14th, hungry and fatigued, saw nothing. September 15th, saw nothing, going home.
Friday, smelt something.
Big pussy sample.
I think I farted.
Oh my goodness.
Insect repellent. We all know what that is.
What is it? Is it
pork?
What piece of that meat?
Pork.
That's pork?
Oh, yeah, pork.
You want something?
Get down on that.
Oh! 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 Oh!
Whoa! Perdomos. Nice.
Ooh. Whole bag of smokes.
Wow.
That's awesome. Look at the size of that.
Is that the whole ear or half the ear?
Oh, it's good though.
All right. I think I got the foreskin.
You guys ready for this one?
Yeah.
Ooh. No way.
Replacement.
So that's another stealth phone.
That's a new one.
Oh. You gotta be kidding me.
That's a new one.
Now, because Keebler-san is actually not here with us today, we have to use this to our advantage with him somehow. We're gonna have to come up with something to throw him for a whirl. Mm, look at that.
Good. Dude, this sweet. Is good stuff.
This is sweet.
This thing's heavy.
Wow. For its weight?
Whoa.
Yeah.
Well, oh, your,
Keebs, get into the hippie bait. Let me show stuff, Keebs.
For use only, though.
This one's special for Keebler. We'll have to take this to one of the fests.
Yeah.
All right, man, get down on that.
It says for outdoor use only, but my hookah is an indoor hookah. Can you smoke this stuff?
You can smoke,
you can smoke anything.
Okay, all right.
Wow.
That's funny.
Those are for the feral hippies.
Yeah.
We can bait them away from wherever it is we want to go.
Keebler, what are you doing?
Oh, well, Bill and Cliff had sent us this hippie repellent, and we're going to be out here detecting tomorrow, and I want to make sure there's no hippies, so they sent this hippie repellent. Oh, this ain't repellent, it's patchouli. Oh, that's not going to keep them away. That's going to
attract them.
They're going to attract them. Oh, man. Oh, gee. Well, thanks, Bill and Cliff, but it's not repellent. This attracts hippies. I put like a half a bottle out here. Let's get out of here quick. Wow, look, amazing, huh? 5.5 hours ago, I was out here this morning baiting this place with patchouli oil. Look at all the hippies. Hey, do I get one of these? Okay, hey, is there a lot of hippies in here?
Oh, there are too many to even think of.
Wow.
There's so many hippies.
Too many hippies?
200,000.
Wow. It's amazing what a little patchouli oil will do, huh? Hey, you aren't kidding. That place is full of hippies.
I told you.
Man,
unbelievable.
That's
go down there. You'll find more.
More hippies
more
down there? Okay.
Awesome.
All right. Hey, thanks.
You're
hey, do you smell patchouli?
What?
Do you smell patchouli oil?
What's up,
yeah, me too.
Whoa.
So I hear they can smell it from 2 miles away.
Yeah. 2 miles?
Yeah.
Wow. So that brings it in.
That's awesome.
Indian war artifacts from Colorado.
Ooh.
IDs on back where known.
Wow. Look at that.
Holy moly.
That's cool.
Beautiful display.
Look at that.
We got bucking balls, musket balls, Manet balls, 3 ringers, 2 ringers. I don't know what that is. That one of those. That. Ring a ding ding.
Wow, that's a beautiful display.
That is that awesome. A button? That's a
button. That is going to look
awesome. That's going to shine in the shack.
Yeah.
Wow.
No doubt.
This thing's like a puzzle.
Is that the mystery box?
Go ahead, Bob.
This is the surprise box.
Oh.
Surprise, it's a box.
Surprise.
It's got a dirty thing in it.
Yeah.
J-Mo, get ready.
Bill, Cliff, thanks.
You put some real effort into packaging. This
is really cool, man.
I love it.
Wow.
This one says individual bullets for each of our stealth digger friends.
God, isn't
great
it?
Job on the
sweet packaging.
The packaging.
Come on.
Look at that.
Wow.
They're even labeled fancy little, like...
These guys don't mess around. Oh, that'll make a brilliant iPad case.
Is that a spider?
We're going to have to build a whole new wing just to put all the stuff in from today. I like the surprise box. That's actually going to go right under Jay's head.
This is not the bottom of the box.
Yeah.
It says that.
Check this out. Pull, then remove. Who's going to pull the tab?
Not me.
I'll pull it.
That might blow up.
I'll pull it. We better hire a professional, Jay.
Then remove.
Pull it.
This is the bottom.
This is the bottom of the box.
Nice.
Careful, man.
That means you cannot go any lower.
I think you just pull that and slide down.
Pull this?
You know what it looks like to me?
Oh, my God.
Hippies use back door.
Oh, my God. Is that the real deal?
It looks like it, yeah.
The signs, Keebs.
Yeah, I know.
The signs.
They're everywhere.
Oh, my God. That is going.
Jay, you need to turn around.
That's going outside the shack.
Hey, can't you read the signs?
Whoa. That's heavy, man.
All right.
Drag. Well.
Weighs about a pound and a half.
These guys went above and beyond.
Oh, yeah.
That was
that's crazy.
Guys are awesome.
You guys just made for a great... stealthy selfie Sunday morning in the shack.
This is going to give us all we need for the rest of the day.
Yeah, I'm going to get down on that in a minute.
It's Korean barbecue, this one is. Well, I don't know what the other one was.
I think it's the same thing.
Fancy. Is it?
Yeah. Most likely just going to be surface finds around here, so that's why we're not really keeping form with our swings.
And you ain't got your shovel. What do you think, Ivy Cakes? Anything?
You're saying 96, 92.
Yeah? Let's see what's under the stage here. This is for, oh, a crayon. A peanut. But unless I saw a gold coin right there, I ain't going after it. Ooh, a transformer. Found a transformer. Those are cool. Okay, so that's what it looks like now. We're gonna transform it. I'm gonna take it off camera. It might take a while, who knows. Whoa, it just changed right before our eyes.
Now,
oh, what does that do?
I don't know.
Well, I think it's, do that again. I think that's his private parts.
Ew.
All right, well, and there's a transformer. All right, so we're gonna say goodnight to the Hippie Fest location, and it was great. We had a lot of fun. Gonna be driving, we're gonna head back. Maybe we'll even stop by the shack and have a snap. Who knows? All right, but that was rough. The guy sent us patchouli thinking it was hippie repellent.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't, it was patchouli, and they were all over the place. And they got naked, jumped around. It was like, all right, so. So Ivy, what we got?
Some sunglasses.
That was cool.
A transformer.
Yeah.
Some keys.
Keys.
Coins.
Coins.
Smiley face. And an ounce of silver.
Yeah.
Noah's Ark.
Noah's Ark.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, look, 2x2, everything.
Nine.
All right.
Yeah.
Evil one!
Ah! Pick me to your leader.
All right.
Well, that was fantastic. I don't know what else to say, but have a spoon. Myself, Keebler, and Just Bob went out on a Saturday afternoon, and we went to a cellar hole we had spotted weeks before, and this is what happened. All right, well, it's a Saturday afternoon. Myself, JB, and Keebler are out on the hunt. We just stopped off at a spot, and Bob and I combed the place. Nothing.
I found the comb.
Oh, no kidding. Keebler just returned, so.
All right.
How did you do?
Glad you asked.
Because you went off. I don't even know where you went.
Yeah, this back stone wall area.
Yeah.
That leads down to the other place. Well, for starters, number 73.
Oh, my God. Halfway through the summer.
Coin spill. All 70s. They're still 45 years old.
Right.
Yeah.
but probably a hunter or a camper. I would dig these all day long.
Here it comes. You had to put it in the bag.
It is big. In fact, this is the biggest bingo to date. The biggest bingo to date. I'm not lying. This is big. Big. Andy. What was that, Barney Fife? This is big. You know, I'm not up on...
He won't even let me peek in the bag.
No,
it's big.
It takes up the whole damn bag.
He's digging away. I have no idea. Look at him. He's even turned around because he doesn't want us to see it yet.
I should be up more on these than I am, but I'm pretty sure that this is a Colt revolver.
No.
Shut the front.
Navy Colt revolver.
Are you kidding me?
This is an incredible find. Like I said.
Look how happy Henry is. Easy.
I was looking for hippies earlier.
Is that 5 or 6 shots?
JB and I are sitting over on the wall here saying, what a drag today is.
Unbelievable.
That is gorgeous.
Close up.
Guacamole octagon freaking barrel.
Don't point that thing.
Yeah, it's loaded.
Actually, no. Is there anything in the chambers?
No.
It's a percussion gun. See the percussion nipples?
It's unbelievable find.
Okay, that's a fucking killer find, Henry.
Yeah. Woof, woof.
Wow.
That's an incredible find.
He's in overload, man.
And you filmed it?
I filmed the dig, yeah.
So I want to see it. So let's watch that, and then we'll continue on with our day.
Again, way out in the middle of nowhere. I've already flipped this, and I know what it is. This is an incredible find. It is, you know, we find play guns all the time, but that, my friend, is a real, real gun. I think it's the kind Clint Eastwood likes. My word, look at that. Just look at that. Nice revolver. Huge slugs. We'll get, when I get back to the guys, we'll get much better shots of this. I'm sure I can get some serial numbers off from this. Wow. Huh? Unbelievable. That is incredible. Man. Ugh. Make my day. Any hippies over there? Any hippies over there?
Bob, so cool. Bob, so and exciting. I are really sucking today.
That's freaking awesome. Look how, that's what Clint Eastwood had.
No, that was before Eastwood.
No. I mean, like Josie Wales and all that.
Well, Josie
or did
Wales,
he have the ones that?
That is one of those.
It is.
Yes.
That's why you dig like signals that are big and sound awful. Because
I do it all the time.
This right here. Is hinged.
Hinged, isn't that right?
That popped out.
All right, so Keebs has got the upper hand today. Holy crap. Wow. Sick.
Here, look. Just pull it through. All right, not too long ago, I had probably the find of a lifetime. What we have here is a 1858 Remington. It's a cap and ball situation. There's little nipples around here where you put the little caps. 20 to 30 grains of black powder, and you jam the ball in there. It's a loader right in the gun. You just pull this down and it seats that round in there. Two people really noteworthy of this weapon would be William Buffalo Bill Cody. And he's writ that this weapon never failed him. The other being one of my favorites, Clint Eastwood. He had it in a couple different movies. The first one would be Pale Rider, where he played a preacher. He had a couple of these. This was the preferred hand cannon during the Civil War. Remington Beals, as it was known back then, during the onset of the Civil War, the U.S. government needed to get their hands on as many revolvers as they could. The Remington cost 50 cents more than the various Colt models, but due to the top strap framing here, it was more robust than all the Colts that were out there. And once again, the cylinder, once it's loaded, you take that out and pop it in your pocket, you would carry as many as you could, 6, 7, 8 of these cylinders preloaded. many people, if they found them on the ground during battle, would pick them up. They would have one in each hand, each side, in their belts. They were guerrillas. They had 100 rounds on them. I cannot stress enough, people walking through fields, woods, around stone walls, cell holes. Do not pass by the big iron. I never do. As you know, hundreds of oxen shoes, plows, whatever. Until you come up with one of these babies, it's well worth every dig.
So Keebler has been showing that thing to everybody. He couldn't be any more proud of that find. And I cannot blame him. Awesome. So a couple days after that, he and I go out, and we have another Keebler moment, a Keebler find that's kind of like the buckets, if you recall that. Yeah, he calls me on the radio for these things, and well, just watch.
All right, so I went up further up the road, found a hole, and pounded to death. Keeps calls me on the radio, concerned. All right, what do you got, or what do you think you see?
Well, I think I see blue jeans, a hoodie, an orange vest, hat, leant up against the tree. Boy, from this angle, I swear it's a dead guy out there.
You really want that find of the month, don't you?
Well, that is kind of fun.
I hope he's wrong.
Gosh, no, this is the hunter's worst nightmare.
Yeah, man, I hope you're wrong. Well, all right, I can see you now, so be there shortly.
Well, we just left that possible mill site where the cellar hole's full of water, right next to the brook, you know. Nobody ever builds a house next to a brook. So I'm working this old road up here, and about where my shovel is and everything down that sandy area, I keep catching this glimpse of, it's like, oh gosh, there must be a really bright orange tree out there and the sun's hitting it just right, but it wasn't. And as I got closer, it got bigger.
I don't smell anything.
I think it's beyond that. So, if you look right out there, that is a friggin' dead guy leant up against a tree.
Oh my God.
See the arms, the hat, the vest, the pants. I swear, it's a dead guy leant up against that tree. God. I find the weirdest things.
Oh my God.
I think I'm right. I mean,
if that
it's just bones.
Edgar's
left.
Suit is not full of bones, then it's still bizarre.
Yeah. Yeah. At first I thought Mylar balloon. I was like, no, I think that guy's looking at me.
We gotta go look.
No.
You're not going over?
No, because then we gotta call the police. Ah hell. We've already seen it. I mean, keep looking at it. It's, you can see the arms.
Why would anybody even put that out here?
If it was, what, dead guy?
Where we are.
We're the only ones that found it.
This is a class 6 road, meaning they don't maintain it. It's drivable, public land. And it's like 2 miles long, and we're about in the middle of it.
Sure it's not 4 miles when we're in the middle of it?
Feels like it.
Yeah. Uphill both ways. Whoa. Man, that is going to be so weird.
What would you do? Because by the time you're watching this right now, we've already done whatever it is we were going to or not.
So, as of right now, if that is a person, that's the end of my bucket list. I'm done. I'm done hunting. That's it. I've found it all.
Hey, man. I look like a
freaking
skeleton in that.
Come on. All right, I'm going over the wall. Whoa, a stand, Keebs.
Did this guy have fallen out of a tree and died?
Well, he landed sitting up.
Maybe. There's a freaking gun there and everything, I think.
Come on.
Isn't it a gun standing up?
Way too weird, man. Is that a gun right beside it? I can't tell. Is that the gun right beside it?
know what's getting me is the dark hoodie.
Yeah.
Where I can't see anything.
That's definitely a knife, though.
No, this is a prop.
Wait a minute. You know what this is?
I don't know what this is.
I think it's so that deer are accustomed to seeing this out here. So this will scare them when he's out here.
What the flip?
Definitely Blair Witch stuff. That's an umbrella? Oh no, it's a planter. Oh, it's a plant. Okay.
Yeah, I say we just go home now.
Yeah.
God. I mean, more. Look at that from a distance. I mean,
I thought he dead.
Yeah, you ain't kidding.
Who gets the hunter? You or me?
You.
Wow.
Boy, that's amazing and remarkable and exciting that you found it, but then what do you do?
Yeah. What?
You doing an anonymous call? I mean, out here, it's survival of the fitness.
Yeah.
You know?
It's all water under the fridge.
Right, so I wouldn't want to have to get involved with authorities on that.
Yeah. Well, you're an accomplice until you prove otherwise, I think, huh?
Right. Freaking Keebler. Look what hey, guess what I found now?
All I can say is that for a solid 7 minutes between deciding whether to go look or not, and then actually creeping up to it was just... Video will never capture what was going on in here. Never a dull moment. And there'll be more to come every Thursday night, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Until then, stay young and always keep them guessing. Live free or die, and adios.
Back door long hair.
Oh no.
So, we do smoke a lot down here in the shack, and we think Lou likes it, actually.
You guys are getting high.
We can tell by the yellow tinge that Lou's now sporting.
Yeah.
And the fact that every time we come home, back to the shack, all the snacks are gone.
I think he's been actually lighting up himself, and around his mouth is starting to turn real yellow.
Well, when I get back to the shack here, he's rubbing up against the humidor because he wants me to light up. I think he's addicted.
Yeah, he won't even look at cannabis anymore.
No, he wants tobacco.
Yeah, he keeps looking for rolling papers.
Field journal.
Yeah. Saw nothing. Tuesday. Saw nothing. Wednesday.
Heard
saw nothing.
Heard something.
Yeah,
heard Thursday. Something. Heard something.
Friday, smelt something.
Big
so we got another driving with Keebler moment. He just could not resist pulling over for that.
It said free.
We got a nice buckle. Didn't have to dig that. What else we got? Gems? Cufflinks. Matched set. Nice. Bob got himself some juggling balls or squares. Just blue sound effects. Now let me do the purr and then you do the wheeze.